Hello friends, today we are going to learn how to use morphs imported into Unreal Engine 5 with the Daz Studio figure. Let's get straight into it. Start Unreal Engine 5 and select the third person GAN template. Let's name the project Daz Morphs Tutorial and hit the Create button. Go to Edit, Plugins, start typing Daz2 and enable the Daz To Unreal plugin. It requires restart. After restart, go to Edit, Project Settings, find the Plugins section and Daz To Unreal settings in the left column. Check the fixed bone rotation and zero root rotation. Now, let's go to Daz3D. I have already prepared the model. Make sure the figure is selected in the Scene tab. Go to File, Send to, Daz To Unreal. Type the asset name in the tab. Let's name it Daz Girl. Check the Enable Morphs box and hit the Add Morphs button. Start typing breasts up and add the breasts up down morph. Just select and press Add for export. And we see it in the right column now. Alright, now let's add breasts side morph. Now, search for eye look and add I look side and I look up down morphs. Now let's search for some facial expressions. I search for smile and I add some morphs for smile. If you don't have these exact morphs, that's alright, just add some that you do have. I am adding so many morphs just for example. We will actually be using only breasts, eyes and blinking in this tutorial. However, after you learn this, you will be able to use other morphs with ease as well. Alright, we may save this preset to load it later when exporting other figures. Click the Save Preset button. And let's save it as in Daz G8F Basic Preset. Hit the Accept button. Make sure Show FBX dialog setting is enabled. Accept one more time. Disable exporting animations. And we are ready to export our girl. Press the Accept button. It may take some time. Alright, so it is imported into Unreal Engine 5. Open the content drawer. Navigate to Content, Daz to Unreal, Daz Girl. Let's delete this animation asset. Under the Daz Girl folder, let's create a new folder. Name it Animations. Now, navigate to Characters, Mannequins, Animations. Let's right-click the animation blueprint named ABP Queen and click Retarget Animation Assets, Duplicate and Retarget Animation Blueprint. In the IK Retargeter, we should select the G81 Fixed Rod Zero Root IK Retargeter. But just in case, if you don't see it, return to the content drawer and open the settings menu at the top right. Make sure that both show engine content and show plugin content options are enabled. And now once again, we retarget our animation blueprint. And voila, now we see the G81 fixed or zero root IK retargeter. We select the SKM queen as a source and our Daz girl as a target. And here at the right, let's change the folder to the Daz to Unreal Daz girl animations. Let's set a prefix for all other retargeted animation assets. Type here Daz girl and hit the retarget button. Alright, it looks pretty nice. And now, let's select these two animation blueprints, ABP Mani and ABP Queen. We can do it with the left mouse button, holding Ctrl on our keyboard. Let's drag them level up to the Daz girl folder. Select Move here after the menu appears. Go to the Daz girl folder and edit the Mani animation blueprint. Have you noticed? We have retargeted ABP Queen only, but the ABP Mani has been retargeted as well, as it is a parent class for ABP Queen. If you don't see these nodes, click the anim graph at the left. Now, select the control rig node and in the details tab at the right, change the default class to CRG8 basic foot IK. Save, compile and close the window. That's it with retargeting. And now we can start working with morphs in our animations. Today we are going to edit only one animation, this Daz girl MF walk forward. Let's open it. We are going to start with the breast side morph. You see this animation is looped and there are a kind of middle step point when the legs and feet are at the middle of the movement. And there are full step points when either the right or the left foot is forward and back. Near the curves section in our timeline, click that little triangle icon. And under the Add Curve menu, select our breast side morph. And here we see a new track. If you double click it, a new editor timeline will open for this specific curve. But we can always get back to our main timeline. You see this tab at the top. Alright, let's right click the curve somewhere near the start and we see an option to add a key. Let's add it. We can also do it with the middle mouse button. And let's set the value of this first key to 1. And you see the breast has moved right. The entire line has moved to that position. We can change to the normalized view mode to see it better without scrolling too much. Now, let's move our playhead a little bit forward, maybe here, and add to 1 more key, and set its value to the opposite, I mean -1. Alright, you see it? The breasts have moved to the opposite side. Let's now try adding this key somehow related to when she makes steps. One more here, and the value is 1. You know, 1 and -1 are actually too much. We could try saying 0.5 and -0.5. But now let's leave it as is. A little bit exaggerated, but we see how it works. We can change these values later to look more natural. And here is another step. Add the key and its value is -1. By the way, sometimes I cannot see the changes. I guess it is a bug. And you see this post-processing button. If I disable the post-processing and enable it again, it starts working. Alright, and now drag the playhead somewhere near the end of the animation. As this animation is a loop, the last keyframe should have the same value as the first one. So it loops smoothly. Add a new key and set the value to 1. Alright, so it works. Now, right click somewhere on empty space and select all keys. And now right click and set the interpolation mode to auto. It gets applied to all of the keys and it makes the movement smoother. So, we have applied our first morph to the animation and it was pretty simple. Now let's make the breasts move up and down. The same way, we add a new curve and select our breasts up-down morph. Double-click to open the curve editor. I think the breasts move up when the girl makes that full step. I mean when her feet are far from each other. And the breasts move down in the middle of step. Let's this time first add the start key and the end key. We remember their values should be the same, so the animation loops smoothly. So we add a new key near the start and we add one more key somewhere near the end. We leave their value 0 for now. And now, let's first add all the other keys. And we will set their values later after we add all of them. So, we add a new key every time when she makes a full step and every time when she is in the middle of a step. I add them slowly so you can follow me. But remember that you can also add keys with the middle mouse button. So, we have added all the keys. Let's now right-click on an empty space and select them all. Now, we right-click once again and set the interpolation to auto. Now, click anywhere on an empty space to deselect all the keys. And select the second key. And let's set its value to 0.7. Now, we skip one key and select the next one, where she makes a full step again. It is the fourth key. And you know what? There is no need to set this key's value exactly 0.7. In the real world, the amplitude may vary, so let's set it to 0.6. And we skip one more key and select the next one. And let's set it to 0.65. And once again, we skip one key and we select the next one and set it alright to 0.7. Alright, it works. It is not so exaggerated as our breast side-side curve. It might even look like nothing has changed. But if we select a key and set a higher value, say 1 or even 10, we see that it actually works. Alright, let's close the curve editor. So, that's basically it with the breasts. We will possibly reduce the side-side amplitude later. But I believe you have already got the idea about how this works. Now, let's add some micro movements and blinking to her eyes. Some of the future tutorials will be dedicated to the basics of cinematics. And you know, people's eyes and facial expressions are always changing. And when we add these details, it looks much more realistic. So, we first add a curve with our eyes look up down morph. And I will speed up the recording of the process. Basically, we just add some eye movements with a little amplitude. And the process is absolutely identical to the process we learned before. The only thing, don't forget that in a looping animation, the first key and the last key should have identical values. Thank you. Alright, and now let's add one more curve with the eyes look side side morph. And I speed up the process as well, so you don't fall into sleep. And now let's also add a curve for our eye blink morph. I speed up the process as well, but you can see that we add one quick blink and one, let's name it semi-blink, during our animation cycle. And absolutely the same way, you can slightly change your facial expression during the cycle. You remember we have exported some of them. For my example, I have added a curve for a Victoria 8.1 subtle smile morph. And finally, as you might have noticed, when Daz figures get imported into Unreal Engine 5, their mouth is slightly open. Let's close her mouth in this animation cycle. We are not going to use morph for this. At the left of our window you can see the tab named Skeleton Tree. Let's type jaw in the search box and select the lower jaw bone. And you see, we can rotate it in different directions. We actually need this jaw rotation around the green axis. But it is rotating a little bit too much. So let's undo it and adjust the speed of translation and rotation in our editor. Just use these two icons at the top right and set the scaling values to the minimums. And now we rotate her jaw once again and her mouth is now closed. After doing this, click the plus key at the top bar. And it will add a separate curve for our new jaw position. And if you want to, we can animate her jaw rotations as well by changing the curves.